Listen to this track, bitch. Hey.
Hey. What is up? We are back. We have Locksmith. Man ain't been on the chan in a minute. Alright. So hopefully we ain't missed too much. But I bought his album last year. I enjoyed it. I love listening to his freestyles on the radio. On the radio stations and stuff like that. He is a great MC in my opinion. Remember, my opinion. And some others will agree. They know who they are. So it's always interesting. But this is Grind by Locksmith.
And here we go.
Landmark Entertainment in a world.
Yo, everybody wanna be a god, everybody wanna be a deity, everybody wanna cling on to the earth, nobody wanna break free of thee. Mental jail that is meant to jail with the lower side of your potential self. Whatever sent you veil will extend and pale in comparison to your eventual hell.
Yes.
Nothing is special. They pressure, they stress you, they force you to give up and follow it. Rappers, they bicker and beef it for nothing. They fight with each other like Catholics and Protestants.
Extra
books, aggression cooks, and no one expects to look underneath what is known to the streets. It is blown out of proportion like a portrait that I paint. Trapped in a quaint little hole in the rich where the skinny niggas die and you can't fly out of that cage till I stepped on the stage and I let my emotions comply. Confide with a similar sentiment to the spirit that was given to the independent mind frame. Niggas claim that they're willing to ride and sacrifice any vice. My vice get on my frame. They just keep rapping about money and bottles and models and models and hollows and how they just cop the new yacht in the grotto. But what is it worth if you shallow? How do you swallow and bury the truth? Living out your life vicarious through me, but it's meaningless. Niggas keep dreaming and thinking that they can be sharing this too. I enter when it's inferred that I'm in first, that I immerse in the inverse what has been perched on a large scale. Auction and sale, another lost soul that can pimp worse. Worst case is to worst 8 minutes spent on a couple new songs in the first place that you never should have listened to. This is what we differ through. People talk about it when they limit you. I'm living with a little bit of a chip on my shoulder. They really want me to slow up, but I'm focused on my end game. If you really think about it, every stage I was doubted, but the faith in myself, it was ingrained. Every cell of your membrane, every failure I sustained. I've been dealing with a lot of adversity, but my lyric diversity had me judged in a whole nother light. Let me explain what another might do. They get claps and praise, do the same, get attacked with a match and blaze. Passion plays a part in my detached from craze. Niggas trying to drag me in the trap they laid. Keep a fuck about your accolades, acts of rage, spitting to a bastard's face, bash his face, leaving with an aftertaste, a massive case of being pissed off because I passed his pace.
Oh, I already have that album. This must be later. This must have been beforehand. My bad. I thought this was like the new new. I was gonna say, I can't wait. I already have that one. And I don't remember Grime being on there. This might have just been a promo for like Olive Branch. He should have put it on there. Because he was spitting hard. Man, I've been missing that type of lock. Thing is, new album coming out this year. I think it's going to be time to get back into the Locksmith. Ooh, Locksmith. Everybody wants to be a god. Everybody wants to be a deity. Everybody want to hold on to the earth. Nobody wants to break free of thee. The mental prison, mental, I don't know. I just, that part went hard enough for me to remember it. But, does everybody want to be a god? Some people like being gods. Some people like being deities. You see people get all these humongous followings and all this other type of stuff. And it's just like, what are you actually doing for these people? Besides nothing. It's like churches and stuff. Breaking free from the mental prison. If everyone broke free from the mental prison, the earth would be in total chaos for like probably a couple of years. Like, real talk, people need this rat race systematic setup because they are afraid of chaos and they are afraid of free thought, basically. Like being on a time schedule is like prison. You know, you're on a time schedule. You gotta do this, you gotta do this, you gotta do this. It's the same thing out here, just different. We can choose not to get out of bed some days, but you can only choose so many days or you're gonna be looking for another place of employment. So you get up. Even when days you hurt and you be like, I'm just gonna have to work through it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's kind of the same thing. It's still a prison, just with more options. Anyways, I'm not gonna get that deep into it because y'all know how I do. We'll be here all night. That's why the podcast is coming next week. Yes, your boy found a way to record the podcast from his phone. That way, when I'm on the phone with people, I'm recording the podcast. So I'll have some solo podcasts, and then I'm also going to have some joint podcasts with people. So be ready for that. It'll be happening. I'm going to make sure I do it 3 times a week, though. 3 times a week, and it's going to be free thought. I really want this to be motivated and basically pushed by you guys. So I'm probably going to be looking to start asking you guys, what should we talk about in the podcast? Because I want it to be of your interest. You know what I'm saying? Not just some stuff. Because I'll talk about anything. I will. If I know about it, I'll talk about it. If I don't know about it, I'll just be like, to the left. Your boy's Nixon.